Hello everyone. Now, in the chapter number 8, economic reforms, we are going for the further topics. One, that about privatization, then its process of privatization, then the portion of globalization and its process, and finally, we are ending our session with completion of types of foreign investments. Okay, so let's start the topic with the particular one, that is privatization. Now, what is called as privatization? The process of introducing private owners into a publicly owned enterprise. It means what you are doing, you are implementing or imposing some of the private owners in the public enterprises. That means there are some of the public enterprises are there and you are allowing some private owners to invest their money into their public organizations. Okay? Now, how we are going to do that? So, what is the process of privatization? So, there are major 3 points in that particular process. Number 1, that is through the disinvestment. Second, by reducing numbers of reserved public sectors. If you know, if you have seen the previous video, in that we have discussed, there are particularly at present 3 sectors which are fixed for public sectors only. Now, we are reducing them. And the third one, that is by establishing PPP model. What is PPP stands for? Public-private partnership. Okay, so now let's start with the first topic or the first point, that is through disinvestment. Now what is called as disinvestment? You are allowing some private owners to invest their money into public enterprises. Okay, so there are major 2 types how you can do a disinvestment. One, that is fully disinvestment. Second is a partial one. Now what is fully disinvestment? Where you are allowing the private owners to invest 100% of their capital and purchase whole shares, that is called as fully disinvestment. Now what is called as private disinvestment? Okay, private disinvestment means where you are allowing the private owners to invest some of the money. Some in the sense, it is also divided into 2 parts. One, that is minor disinvestment, and second is major disinvestment. Okay, so what is major disinvestment? When you are allowing them to invest more than 51% in the shares, that is called as major disinvestment. And if you are allowing them to invest less than 51%, that is called as minus disinvestment. Okay? So that is the first point. Now we are going to the second one, that is reducing reserved public sectors. If you know that in the starting of the year 1951, there are only 5 public sectors. Now, it has changed the scenario. In the year 2015, there were more than 300 public sectors. Now, let's see the latest data. At present, there are 120 public sectors in the market. Okay, so what we are doing? We are reducing the numbers of public sector and giving the ownership to the private owners. Okay, then, in this particular, we are only allowing them except the 3. First one, that is atomic energy. Second one, that is few minerals. Which minerals which are reserved for the government, and the third one, that is railways. Okay, now the third number, that is by introducing PPP model. What is called as PPP? Public private partnership. Okay, where there is a public owners and the private owners, they are coming together for a particular objective. The objective is to welfare the society, for the profit making, anyone can be done. So there are some examples. One, that is DRDS. Second, that is Mumbai Metro Rail Services. So these both are the PPP models which are introduced. And if you know the services about both the industries, you can compare it with any of them. You can see that. Okay. So this model is more positive, more effective in concern of economy. Now, so that is about our privatization portion. Now let's go to the globalization. So what is called as globalization? The process of increasing countries' interference with the rest of the world, where you are allowing your country to invest the money in the different countries, your company to do trade and commerce in different countries, that is called as globalization. That means you making the whole world narrow and spreading your business in the whole country, whole world. Okay. Now, what is the process of globalization? So, how we are going to follow or how we are going to implement the process? First one, there are some simpler import and export schemes. Okay, the policy has become more simpler. Previously it was very difficult. Then second one, that is India. Okay, India has become the member of WTO, World Trade Organization, in the year 1995. So after 1995, we are allowed to do trade in the whole world. That means in the member countries. The members of WTO, they are allowed to do business in our nation and we are allowed to do business in their nations. Okay, moving to the next point, that is foreign exchange rates. Previously, it was decided on the basis of official rates. Now, that has changed to the market-based rates. So that means official rates are declared by the government and we have to follow that schemes and we have to apply that rates when we are doing your business to the rest of the world. Instead of that, now we will apply the market rates which are fixed by the whole country. Next, the sector wise and the systematic increase in FDI. What we are doing, we are allowing FDI but in some of the way. For example, previously in the retail sectors we have allowed 49%, but now at present we have allowed 100% of FDI in retail sectors. Same way in the theaters we have given 100% of FDI allowance. Okay. Then the fifth one, that is increase the financial collaboration with the other countries. What we need to do in this? We have to increase our collaboration with the different countries. That means India is making collaboration with the US, India is making collaboration with China, India is making collaboration with the rest of the world. Okay. So by that way we can go in the process of globalization. Then the next point, that is social and cultural ties. Okay, now what we need to do? When we are doing our business in the rest of the world, we first need to understand what are their social and cultural. We have to understand the social economic conditions. Same way we need to understand their culture. As per their culture, we have to sell the products. So finally, the sixth point is there. So this is the process of globalization. Now when you are following the process of globalization, you have to do an investment. So there are main two types of investment. Let's start with the first one, that is FII, foreign institutional investment. So what is called as foreign institutional investment? Everyone has heard about the word FDI, which everyone knows that you are allowing someone to invest their money in our country in the forms of capital, in the forms of plant and machinery. They were establishing a new unit in your area and finally they were doing trade in your country. That is called as FDI, that is a basic one. But what is FII? Some of the people who are not interested in investing their money into plant and machineries. So what they were doing, they were implementing or they are imposing their money by way of shares or bonds. That means they were investing in our share market. There are some prescribings for each and every country. But what they are doing, they were purchasing shares and bonds of our country. There is some mediators, that means some institution, we are doing work as a portfolio managers and they were allowing them to invest their money in our country. Okay, so in that situation what we are doing? If you know that if you purchase an equity shares, that means you become the owner of the company. That means a part of the share, you become the owner of the company. But in the condition of foreign institutional investment, you are not allowed to become the owners. That means your participation in that particular shares is not allowed. That means you only can invest in home countries, but you can also invest in this particular foreign institutes by the way of FIIs, but you are not getting a type of management in that particular situations. Okay, now this investment is a particular for a short term. When you are going to get good profits, they will withdraw the money, and by this way this will be called as foreign institutional investments. Okay, that's all for today. Thank you.